What is going on, everybody? My name is Pete, but you probably already knew that. But in case you didn't, you guys are watching the one and only Paid to Drive. And of course, Pay to Drive Vlogs coming at you with another new video. Hope you're all doing fantastic out there, my friends. That's right. So, ladies and gentlemen, if you drive for apps like Grubhub, DoorDash, Uber Eats, or any of the others, you're in the right place to stay up to date with what is going on in the gig economy. So get started right now for free. Hit that red subscribe button down below and turn on all notifications so you're always notified whenever I post something new. And of course, don't forget to hit that like button down below. Just lets YouTube know I'm doing a good job. And let's jump on into this triple Lindy Thornton Melon style. So we're going over some more of your feedback from a previous video that I had made about drivers finally getting some justice. Finally, justice for drivers. It's coming to an end with the customer fraud. That's right. So basically, to sum up that video, this was about Uber and Uber Eats doing something now where if customers who are trying to scam drivers and scam Uber and you know, the system here, customers who sign up on Uber with like Visa gift cards or like prepaid debit cards will now be required to provide identification or ID with a license or a passport or any sort of anything that can prove who you really are, you know, to prove who you are. There you go. And I gotta say, the responses were very, very interesting on this. So listen up. And, you know, again, I wish DoorDash and Grubhub would do more of this as well, because it would really cut down on all of this nonsense with the fraud. Leonard Torrance says, it's long overdue, but let's not forget, it's Uber, the king of reversing anything good for drivers. I honestly feel it's a bait and switch. They're just trying to give more reasons for drivers to come back. It's a welcome change, but I won't hold my breath if it's still here by the fall. Well, Leonard, honestly, I want to try and stay as optimistic as possible, because we know there's a ton of negativity, you know, in the gig economy in general with the way these apps play games with us. So I want to try and stay optimistic, but I hear you. So Tom says, DoorDash needs to come up with a way to prevent all scams, not just the debit card scammers. This debit card requirement just prevents 1% of all scammers. What about the majority of customers that use credit cards? Well, I feel like some of them are doing it with a credit card, but you don't want to have that tied to your name, especially these scammers. So I don't know if it's happening on credit cards as much as it is like the prepaid, like anonymous ones. Leslie Petty Brycheson says, hey Pete, I sent you a Facebook message a while back. By the way, guys, don't send Facebook messages. I'm not responding on there anymore because it's just too much of a mess. paytodrivestories@gmail.com for the future reference. I've been on DoorDash since May 2020 and have thankfully not encountered many issues. I do like the idea of a PIN number when the customer wants the food left at the door. It would cut back on the fraud a lot, in my opinion. Thanks for the informative content. Leslie, no problem. I know you're talking about like the Uber PIN thing, which is kind of tied into the whole situation with the fraud. So we'll have to see where it goes. A. Newman says, the last thing they should do is blame the driver. I mean, especially the veteran drivers. It's BS. I agree 110% with you. Abouts says, I had this happen the first time over yesterday. It makes me sick because I only had two Jersey Mike orders, and both of them I handed the food to the customer. One of them said drop off, but of course, as I'm walking to the door to place it to take a picture, here comes the customer to open the door. I didn't think much of it at first. Then I checked my ratings during my dash when it got slow, and bam, contract violation. Shake my head. I contacted DoorDash and told them about it. I don't know if they'll remove it or what. I was told the info was forwarded to the proper people, and that's it. Now, I know you did bring up DoorDash because the issue is just as bad on there as any of the other apps. But yeah, something definitely has to be done on DoorDash regarding this. What's ridiculous is why they waited so long to do this. And if everybody else does not follow, that would be even dumber. I agree with you. I agree with you, Steve. And Tom again says, I am tired of this debit card news that only 1% of customers use. The best thing to prevent fraud is to require the customers to tap confirm in the app within 5 minutes of the food being delivered, or else they have no dispute rights. If they don't mark the order not delivered within 5 minutes, the app will automatically count the order as delivered and no further action can be taken. I happen to like that suggestion quite a bit. So yeah, drivers, everybody in the chat, in the comments, let me know. What do you think of what everybody said here? And would you have any suggestions about how to cut down on the customer fraud? Let us know down below. And of course, like I mentioned earlier, if you guys ever want to send me anything for a video, if you have a topic or a question or whatever, send me an email. The best way to reach me is at paytodrivestories@gmail.com. That information's in the description. Or if you'd like to get a quicker response from me, you can actually message me through Patreon at patreon.com/paytodrive. So that link is in the description down below or in the pinned top comment. And anyone who does sign up on Patreon, I shout you guys out in all my new videos, which I'm about to do right now. So when you hear your name called, say, "Hey, Pete, I heard my name." We've got the very generous Ari Rosenbaum, our $100 ultimate driver. Thank you, Ari. The very generous Samantha Mikles, Brian Pomeroy, Brian Medina, Heidi Barnes, Ivan Jerome Gilroy, Joe Valerio, Angela Counts McCarty, Kurt Paul, Lee Peacock, Tulsa Todd, William Boudreau, Laura Love, Agus, Tom Perry, Alan G. Van Horn, Lawrence Brown, Drew Hanor, Fernando Carranza, Frank Haviland, Fresh One, Jason Kasta, Justin Case, Lulu Laura, Natalie Mosley, Sarah Keston, Scott Freisner, Sherry Cassidy, Stephen Neely, Joyce Hine, Brian Richardson, Kenny Bess, Jenny Thomas, John Bonacci, Matt Epperson, Nick G., Stacy Miller, Terrence Pacheco, and of course, Valerie Brown. Huge shout outs to all of you. So yes, sign up on Patreon down below. Who's going to be the next patron? I don't know. Could it be you? We'll find out. And I hope all of you guys are saving money with the Get Upside Gas app every time you go to the gas pump. There's a link down below for the free app all the way at the bottom of the description. You click on that. It'll tell you how to download it to your smartphone. Any kind of phone will work. You go to your gas station, pump your gas, print out your receipt, take a picture of your receipt with the Get Upside Gas app, and within 48 hours or so, you'll get anywhere from 15 cents to 45 cents a gallon back, which is pretty fantastic. And if a friend or family member signs up using your code, you'll get paid every time they pump gas. It's called Get Upside. Links in the description down below. Make sure to download it. And of course, for all your t-shirts, hoodies, and goodies, check out paytodrivestore.com, where everything is on sale every single day. Different designs, colors, sizes, you name it, we probably have it over at paytodrivestore.com. Link is in the description or in the pin top comment. Excuse me. And of course, if you made it to the end of this video, I'm very grateful for all of you. Leave a comment right now saying end 555, END 555. Just lets me know you made it to the end. Hit that free red subscribe button down below and turn on all notifications so you're always notified whenever I post something new. And of course, hit that like button down below. Just lets YouTube know I'm doing a good job. So until next time, get that money, get that honey, keep hustling and keep bustling, and we'll see you next time right here on Paid to Drive and Pay to Drive Logs. That's right. As always, drive safe, be well, and we'll see you on the next one. Peace, everybody. Take care.